Speaker 222 XRP Future Millionaire with the side bet on XLM and Future Digibyte. OG, as always, a special thanks to my man Connor Houston for putting that gem together. So, just I want to share a couple memes from UB2Sob. If you expect perfection from others, the problem lies within you. UB2Sob 111. I totally agree. Some cloud art by UB2Sob, which I fucking love. I appreciate it, my guy. It's spectacular. This soothes the soul. I love it. I have a few more to share from UB2Sob, but we'll get into that later. Connor Houston, my man for making that Sunny Days remix. And I only said it that way one time, and he caught the best way I said it. So, if you look at the patterns logically now that we have some more stasis points, guys, we can start to figure out these patterns. A lot of people are calling for a epic crypto run. Crypto to 100 to 200,000 right now. That's what you're seeing on YouTube. XRP to blast off in regions unknown. Well, I will leave you guys with this. XRP had 2.5 times the volume last time it broke the $1 level and continued upwards than it has right now. You can read into that however you want. We have significantly less volume. You can also read into this however you want. It looks to be a left shoulder and a double top formation on the head. It's creating right in front of our very eyes at that upper resistance on Bitcoin that I told you where the apex was. We're in that apex zone now. This is the official apex zone. We crossed over that slash in between. This area, I said, once we got in here,
well, it's a little bit bigger,
where it's at right now, that's the apex. It can go anywhere from 46.6. That's where I called, by the way. This is exactly where I thought it was going to go to. And I said there is the chance that we could create a bigger top and we could end up at like 47.5 or possibly in this multi-apex zone, which is where everything was leading right here. Real quick, for everybody with Matic, I told you guys that was the next one to pump. And I even drew it out for you guys, told you when to buy in. I should have myself, but like I said, I was busy and I was doing other things. That doesn't mean you guys shouldn't buy in. It went to the exact zone we pointed to. That's sort of in the apex, and that's why it's like that. And it hit it beautifully. That was from our top-down analytics. I even told you guys the range to buy in from 105 to 1, or what was it, $1 to $1.07 range. So, anybody who was on that made 30%, and I'm really happy about that because there's a lot of people making a lot of money, and it's making me very happy. A lot of very, very happy messages, and sometimes I focus on the negativity. But let me tell you, I've received a ton of people that are thrilled with VeChain, Zill, DG, all of it. Even the people that were asking me about T-Fuel, they're like, Tom, you were right. T-Fuel did exactly what you said. I said exactly. That's why I wanted to buy T-Fuel, but I couldn't. I'd have been all over T-Fuel. And I don't think it's done. You see, it's coming to my descending support resistance lines now that it moved to the next level. But again, I'm proud of these calls. These are things that I've been talking about over and over and over. SNX, we talked about, was going to make a breakout. It hit exactly where we were talking about. It's almost up into that zone. So, there's been monster calls here, guys, day after day after day. People are making a lot of money. Doge, we talked about how it should get up to that upper region. And it actually hit exactly where I thought it was going to right now. But like I said, I got busy with my classes yesterday, and the moment to buy where I was going to, I always miss the opportunity because I'm teaching classes. But that doesn't mean you guys should miss the opportunities. There's certain things I won't miss the opportunities on. XRP. Like I keep saying, if you don't like XRP, get your boots on and get the fuck out. So XRP, I would say the same thing. We came through, created a nice... Remember I said yesterday this looked to be the neckline creating, and then we were going to form a head to the top. And if this is what's happening, that's the perfect head to the top. We've got to watch that and see if this is how it plays out. I have these targets for a reason. These were the upper zones. These are the relevant zones. We had at length and nauseam discussions on why we thought it could get to where it could go. Now you have to make a decision. We've officially got up to the top of the cup. Pushed out the top a little bit. Theoretically, now a lot of people are talking about, oh, it got to this far because we could get to 110. That's why my upper line was there. It's going to take a lot to get there. But everybody seems to think now the next move from here, not worrying about any other resistance points, this is the next move. So every single YouTube station is talking about how XRP is going to that handle at 170. If that's the case, why aren't you buying? Why haven't you been buying? If you really believe it's going to 170, by all means, we're still under a dollar. Take your bet. But I can only do what I'm doing. XLM's almost to our 34-cent target. So this is no surprise what's happening, guys. In fact, it's come all the way up to almost 34 cents now. We've been talking about this ad nauseum. So, T-Speaker 222 XRP, Future Millionaire with a side bet on XLM and Future Digibyte OG. We're getting towards these formation tops now. And 46.6 is the area I've been saying we got to watch with Bitcoin and see if it's going to move to the next level. I mean, it's literally jam-packed right within my spot now, so... very, very difficult to determine when the end of this pattern is going to be, but it's quickly getting there, ladies and gentlemen. Stay true, stay blessed, hashtag be better, do better. Hit that motherfucking like button, subscribe, and share this far and wide. Turn that bell notification to all. I know I've got a few people that are watching that have about 100, now about 50,000 subscribers. Share my channel, help me get the word out. Stay